What's up guys, Nature here back with another video, and today we're going to be doing the top 10 PvE units with Crisis Blazing. And yeah, so Crisis did up to 6, and I will continue from 5. And if anything you want to say, Crisis and Shade?
Mayonnaise.
What about you, Shade?
And my existence is something to question in the very lives of others.
Alright, so let's just get into the video. Let's get into the video, guys. Okay, so the first unit we do have is 7-star Kakashi. Now, he is a heart type, and how to awaken him, you have to use the 7-star scrolls as they give you in the guide to give you. Alright, so his pros is that you can change the typing on his landing skill to skill, and then you could do like Heart Naruto to finish him off or something like that. He does juicy spice of damage. And yeah, his con is that he's single target only, and his AoE, he's AoE on his thing, but I think the most jutsu that you use now is his lancing skill. So that's what I said, he's mostly single target, but he has one AoE that attacks everybody that does decent amount of damage. And he does have high chakra cost, so if you don't have it maxed out, most people don't have it maxed out, so that's what I said. His ninjutsu is single target, his ultimate is AoE, his lantern is single target, as I said. His health and strength is pretty decent, his speed is pretty decent in PvP too. In PvP, he's maxed out, he's also one-shots a lot of characters. His PvE, he does tank, he is a pretty good tank in PvE, yeah. And yeah, this is gonna end it for the Kakashi. Let's just get into the next one.
And next up we have Hashirama Senju, or otherwise known as Crit Hashi, the hardest hitting unit in Blazing, easily. So, maximum health, 2,764, max strength, 2,322. He's a wisdom type, yes. Field skill, buddy skill. Field skill, boost attack by 200 to 250 and restores 250 to 300 health. Buddy skill, boost critical rate by 3 times and attack by 250. Sync skills, sync with Hidden Leaf, reduces damage taken by 15%. Sync with Senju Clan, reduces damage taken by 15%. Sync with Short Range, reduces damage taken by 15%. Wow. Abilities. First ability, lowers rate of getting immobilized and Jutsu Sealed by 45%. Second ability, nullifies Chakra Recovery Ceiling. Third ability, increases critical rate damage by 2 times. And the next three abilities, 4, 5, and 6, are all the same. Boost critical rate by 4 times, adding up.
So the next unit we do have is 3rd Anniversary Obito. Now his max health is 1,820 without pills. His max strength is 2,516 without no pills. His cost is 100 to 30. If you have him maxed out, it's 30. If you have him without dupes, it's 100. His field skill reduces the chance of receiving a mobilization by and jutsu sealing by 30% and 40% each, not field skill. Buddy skill reduces damage by 30% and 30% chance of dodging an attack. Sync skill with heart reduces body damage taken by 25%. Sync with mid-range, nullifies Jutsu Ceiling. Sync with Uchiha Clan, nullifies Chakra Recovery Ceiling. Sync with all except heart, he nullifies immobilization. Now his Jutsu, his AoE, it is basically one of the most popular Jutsus in the anime. Not the anime, I mean like the game. He probably, like, when you use his Jutsu in like two or more people, it's an ultra combo. And he heals 2,500 health each turn, so that is really helpful. You can keep stacking the health, but the only thing I would say, have at least have one dupe on him, or four dupes in him. At least have one dupe to get that nullify chocolate health recovery to convert, because that's gonna be really game changing. And yeah, anyway, this is gonna end it for Obito. Oh, also, his ultimate, he does get a reset on his ultimate, which is really, really, really clutch. And yeah, he's just a really good unit in general. So let's just get on to number two. This is Obito abilities. He nullifies health recovery ceiling. He does zero chakra Kazusen on ninjutsu 20%. He gets two resets, so that's basically 50%. 25% damage boost against heart, which is really good. 25 damage boost against skill, alright. And 30% chance to dodge attacks. 20% chance to dodge attacks. So 50% chance to dodge attacks, which is really good in general. If you put another Obito behind him, it's an 80% chance to dodge, which is really, really crazy. And yeah, anyway, that's going to be Obito abilities. So actually, let's move on to number two. Next unit we do have is 7-star Sasuke for coming in at number 2. Now his max health is 212 without no pills. His max strength is 2,818 while no pills. His field skills boosts his critical rate by 3 to 4 times. His buddy skill boosts attack by 450. Now his sync skills are bravery boost attack by 300, which is pretty good if you're in PvP or PvE. Now he does sync with Hidden Leaf, nullifies Jutsu ceiling. Uchiha clan nullifies attack weakening. His abilities are ignore substitution, 20% chance to restore one chakra gauge when receiving direct hit attacks. Nullifies immobilization, reduces damage by 35% and 35% chance to dodge. Boosts attack by 4 times during combinations and reduces damage by 35% and 35% chance to dodge, which is really good too. And he's just a really good unit in general. If I was you, I would probably have about 3 dupes on this man, because that nullify mobilization and the nor substitution dupe, and to get chakra back, PvP, that would be a threat, and PvE, which is really good. So, his artwork is amazing, and he is 3-6 chakra. On his ninjutsu, he does have a 85% chance to do poison damage, and he does have a, in PvP, he has a 1 turn immobilization. PvE, he does have a 2 turn. So yeah, let's just get into the next one, or number 1. Guys, so for number one, basically, I think yeah, all knew this, but 7-star Naruto. I mean, like he's just the G, bro. So 7-star Naruto, obviously max health 3,694 wild pills. His max strength is 2,679 wild pills. His field skills to basically boost wisdom attack by 15 to 750, basically like that. The old Naruto, but wisdom. His buddy skills to reduce bravery and wisdom damage by 40%. His sync skills, short range, boost attack by 300. Wisdom nullifies switch ceiling. Hidden leaf nullifies chakra recovery ceiling, or chakra ceiling, basically. Abilities, he reduces damage by 35% on his first ability. His second ability restores 800 health per turn. His third ability nullifies jutsu ceiling. His fourth ability reduces damage by 35%. His fifth ability, I always get stuck up on Naruto. He has 60% chance of immobilization resistance. And his sixth ability is nullify damage reduction effects. So basically, now, PvP, even though we're not talking about PvP, he is a really good tank. He's like one of the best tanks in PvP and PvE. He can one unit Ninja Road maxed out. He's just really good in general. 3-6 chakra, short range. And yeah, he restores 1,500 health every time he uses his jutsu. And you could put him under Kaguya, just for a little tip. You can put him under Kaguya to get to nullify jutsu, to nullify mobilization completely. If you can have him with 5 dupes, so I'm just saying that. And anyway, yeah. So let's just get into the outro. This is gonna end it for the video. If you're new to my channel, make sure you do leave a like and subscribe. And also go check out Crisis Part 1. Show him some love and subscribe to his channel too while you're at it. And I'll put Part 1 in the description. Everything you need to know. And yeah. Anyway, anything y'all wanna say, boys, before we end? Damn.
Molestial.
You're right.
Crisis made me do it, bro. It's not
that recording. Yeah, alright guys. So make sure you do join our Discord server, and yeah, we're out. Peace.